What would the world look like if people felt like they mattered? Welcome to the Lead with Love podcast, exploring what it means to lead with love in business and life. I'm your host, Jada Selner, and in this show, I'll share meaningful conversations to help you, the creative, the entrepreneur, the world changer, reach more people, go after your dreams, and serve your community with love. I appreciate you joining me. Now let's get cozy and start today's episode. Have you ever made a super detailed to-do list or the big brainstorm of it, 100 things that you want to do in this lifetime list, or maybe just thinking about how you want to feel? And with all of these long lists, you feel like you're not doing enough, you don't have enough, you are not enough. And so the question I'm sitting with today is, how much do you think you really need to live a full life? I'm going to share how we can create more space in our daily lives, and that's what I want to talk about in today's first solo episode of Lead with Love. You are listening to episode 105. So I had this conversation with a good friend of mine, Scott Densmore, who passed away in 2015, and he was someone who was a big dreamer, making a lot of things happen with his company, Live Your Legend. And his wife, Chelsea Densmore, is an amazing, amazing woman, great friend of mine. And I remember sitting at the Battery with him in San Francisco, and he brought up this question of what is enough. And I thought this question was so fascinating when we think about success and wanting to create a fulfilling life. And for people who have big ambitions and big dreams and want to serve the world and make a big impact, our metrics of success can become really big. And this constant chase where you feel like you're on a hamster wheel towards success, but also at the same time getting so tired and feeling like you're burning out. So it's this cycle that we can create for ourselves. And so I'm just sitting with this question on how we define success and how we can define and choose our own metrics of what success means to us. And there's this moment in life, right? There's these tiny moments where you feel successful. You feel like you've achieved what you wanted, until we start comparing our lives to others. And we create this longer laundry list of to-dos to match ourselves or chase someone else's dreams and purpose and fulfillment. And so what are you really chasing? And I know when we think about defining success, you know, it can be hard to measure, because how do we weigh money against fame and validation? There are both rational and emotional parts of success, of what do we feel. And for me, I'm a feeler. I'm always like, how do I feel? And the things that I impart to my daughter is, you know, I can see her feeling stressed about school or needing to deliver things on time and wanting that A and the extra credit. And I'm always checking in with her on her stress levels or that anxious energy that she might have around it, and just reminding her that even if you don't get an A, even if you get a B or a C, or you don't pass, I still love you. And really remembering that what I want for her is to be happy. And so I think it's great for us to really check in on what is it that we really want, you know? And there's this constant feeling of not enoughness. And so my question is, what is enough? You know, we feel like we're not enough, we don't have enough, we don't do enough, but do we even know what enough is. And as I say, you know, the ABCs of love in business or in our personal lives is we are all craving that sense of acknowledgement, you know, to really be seen and witnessed by people, and craving that validation from others that we're doing enough, that we are enough. And then that sense of belonging, wanting to fit in with everyone else. And so wondering if some of that comparison that comes up is also us trying to fit in and feel that sense of belonging and connection of like, I'm right there with you. And then connection. Just really desiring to feel connected, not only to others, but to ourselves and to the world. And there was something that I journaled a couple of months ago, and I texted it to my life coach and to my friends. And I just had this aha moment of enough. And when I really wrote down, like, what was enough for me, it really helped me shed my need or desire to be liked by everyone. It's just so fascinating. I just woke up one morning with the thoughts of, I actually don't need or even want more external validation. I don't want to build my laundry list of more accomplishments to prove my worthiness to serve and grow my business and to be fully expressed in my life and love up on the people that matter to me the most. And so I'm curious for you, is there anything in your life right now where you're chasing external validation and building those accomplishments? And I'm just curious why. And there is no right or wrong answer, and there's nothing wrong with craving that. I think we all want that. I remember Oprah, she shared in one of her talks, she talked about no matter who you are, what level of fame or money you've created, after every interview on the Oprah show, people would say, how'd I do? Was that good? Was that enough? And so we're constantly like checking in with the rest of the world. Are we doing this right? Am I enough? Am I showing up the right way? Could I have done something better? And me, my number one strength in the Strengths Finders test is maximizer. So I can get really confused on like, am I, you know, just having this high value for excellence and high quality experiences, or am I teetering in perfectionism and over polishing? And so it's just really fascinating to me how we kind of dance between these two worlds, and we're a walking paradox of I have everything I need, and I also want to strive and go after more and do more because I want to reach my fullest potential and capacity to serve as many people in this lifetime, while also making sure that I am still sane and building a sustainable business where I'm not burning out, because we can't serve when our cup is empty. We truly do have to serve from the overflow so that we don't feel that sense of depletion. So I want to read what I wrote in my journal. So as I said, you know, I woke up with these thoughts of not needing more external validation, accomplishments to prove my worthiness to serve and grow my business. I feel I've accomplished a lot already. And if Oprah comes, awesome. If I reach 7 figures in this next business venture, awesome. But not at the cost of what I really, really want and already have right now. Time and flexibility to travel with people I care about, time and money to have massages and self-care experiences that nourish me, time and resources to have leisure lunches with friends and mastermind and ideate with smart, fun, creative people, and resources like time, money, freedom, and flexibility that allow me to have a team that bring my ideas into the world. Time to lie in the sun and watch my daughter's soccer practices and games. Time to Netflix binge on The Office and New Girl. Time and resources to have date nights with my hubby. Time and resources to volunteer in my daughter's classroom and nonprofit organizations. all of this I already have, and I know how much it costs to maintain this lifestyle. And also space. I need space to create my best work and serve at my highest capacity. And chasing all the external visibility actually takes time and energetic resources. And I don't need to be everywhere. And I don't need to be seen by everyone. So this is what I wrote in my journal, just this aha of really brainstorming a list of things that I really, really want in my life and things that I already have, and just acknowledging that. I think operating in that space of gratitude is so important. Even when you don't have everything that you want, still taking inventory of the things that you already have are so important. I remember when I was building, you know, my second business venture, it was the online business with a family parenting blog, Family Sponge, that then ultimately evolved and turned into Simple Green Smoothies. And I remember, you know, we were negative in our bank account. My husband and I were just kind of like, it was like, don't move was the approach. Like, anytime money is tight, we have this don't move motto, which is like basically don't leave the house because it won't cost us money if we just stay home. We won't buy anything. We won't be spending money on gas and all of those things. But I remember, you know, my husband, he would ask this question of like, when is it my turn? You know, I'm working really, really hard, and he is such a hard worker. I remember one time he had like 5 part-time jobs when we lived in Kauai on top of our brick and mortar business. And he would see other people who were, you know, felt like from his perspective, they were making enough money. They had a home and all of these things, and they were able to travel. And he just wanted to know, like, when was it his turn? And I so felt that, you know, that desire to really want more than what exists. But I remember thinking, for my own way of showing up in my work, that if I operate from a space of lack, or that I don't have what it is that I need, that it actually puts me in a negative state of mind, and I can't create from that space. So I knew that I had to be super grateful and create like positivity, high vibes. And I was like, we have a roof over our heads, and somehow, some way, we're always provided for. Like, money always comes just in time when we need it. And I really love to operate from that place. So if you're listening right now, and maybe you have a moment to just write a quick note of really taking inventory of what are the things that are already going good in your life, and things that you already want, and you want them, you just like, you want to continue to maintain and sustain that in your world, and just being able to be in that spirit of thankfulness of like, this is what I want in my life, and I already have it. So I think being able to make that list. And I love what Matthew McConaughey, he shared in this video when he was receiving his Oscar for Best Actor for his performance in Dallas Buyers Club. It was the 86th Oscars in 2014. And he said, there are 3 things I need each day. Number 1, someone to look up to. Number 2, someone to look forward to. And number 3, someone to chase. And I thought this was so simple and so beautiful. And he said his someone to look up to is God, grace, gratitude. And his someone to look forward to is his family. And his someone to chase was actually himself 10 years from now. So he allowed, instead of his hero or the measurement of success was someone outside of himself, it was actually himself becoming his own hero. And so he's saying, you know, when I'm age 25, I'm going to be chasing that 35-year-old version of myself. And when I'm 35, I'll be chasing that 45-year-old version of yourself. So it's being in this race with yourself versus having this comparison of other people's success and chasing other people's dreams. Being able to chase your future self feels so much more fun and doable and achievable. And also it allows that carrot to keep moving forward, but with a healthy sense of competition. And I know from this chase that we create of chasing our dreams, chasing, you know, this definition of what we believe is success, whether it's in revenue or accomplishments or achievements that you create in your life, then we start to fill our lives with so much stuff in the spirit of chasing those things ahead of us. And we create a lot of that tension, right? That stress, and sometimes can turn into a strain versus can we create that space of a stretch, right? That you can have tension, but it's a stretch that feels expansive, feels like growth versus something that makes us feel stuck and stagnant and like we've hit a plateau. And so I think about how long our to-do lists have become. And we can look at it the same way that we look at food, right? You know, I don't know if you grew up. I know for me, I grew up with like the clean plate club. Like you want to eat everything on your plate, anything that's in front of you, just being able to eat all the food and eat it all up. And we don't learn to listen to our body's signals of what is enough. And so one thing that I teach my daughter is to listen to her body, especially when she's eating sweet treats and desserts and things like that. I really want her to pay attention to the signals of when she is full. And so, say she's eating a bowl of ice cream, I actually ask her to listen to her body as she's eating that ice cream. I'm like, Zoe, you can definitely finish all of that ice cream, but you did just have a big dinner. And so, I just want you to listen to your body. And when you feel like you've had enough, just stop eating. And could we do this same practice in our lives, right? So not just the same way that we do for our bodies, but also in our work. As we fill our days with to-dos, can we pause to see when we are at capacity, when we are full, when our day is like enough, and then stop? Versus that feeling of I'm so busy or I'm not doing enough and I have to keep going, but actually just to really pause and say, like, that's enough. I've done enough. So maybe instead of having a to-do list, we actually have an enough list, and being able to choose that and allowing ourselves to like, okay, I can pause. I cannot feel like I'm on this never-ending hamster wheel of to-dos. And in Lynn Swift's book, The Soul of Money, she says, when you let go of trying to get more of what you don't really need, it frees up oceans of energy to make a difference with what you have. When you let go of trying to get more of what you don't really need, it frees up oceans of energy to make a difference with what you have. So what is it that you already have? What is that enough list? Now, if we're thinking about creating an enough list in our day-to-day and creating that bigger enough list for our lives, then we can start to see when we are actually full and complete. So in my own workday, I try to focus on getting one important task done versus even 3 to 5 important things, because then that really isn't a priority, right? When you have several competing priorities, you've kind of got so many and you feel like, I've got to get them all done. But what if you just chose what was the one most important thing to get done in your day? So in the book, The One Thing by Gary Keller and Jay Papasan, he asks this one question in the book. What's the one thing you can do such that by doing it, everything else will be easier or unnecessary? So really thinking about that when you're thinking about your work day, what is the one thing that I can do that makes things easier or unnecessary? And just picking that one thing for the day. And it's like, I can close my laptop. I can be complete for the day if I complete this one thing. And you might complete it early in the morning, or you might complete it at 8 o'clock at night. But once that one thing is off your list, then you can complete that enough list for the day. And, you know, I am a holistic business coach and consultant, and I really like to look at things from a full holistic approach in our businesses and our lives. So what if instead of making a long to-do list, we make that enough list in three important areas in our lives, and then being really done and complete for your day? And of course, there might be more things that you have on your wish list, but what if you could just choose one? So I love Jonathan Field's book, and I interviewed him in episode 102, and he talks about the three life buckets as how we take care of ourselves, right? So there's the vitality bucket, the connection bucket, and the contribution bucket. And the vitality bucket is about, you know, our health and our wellness and our connection to ourselves, our self-care. And then we have our connection bucket, which is about like the important relationships in our lives. And then we have our contribution to the world, how we choose to add value with service and our creative expression. And that can show up in so many different ways, from giving back to charities, or giving back in your work that you do in the world, or giving back to your family, right? That contribution piece can show up in so many different ways. So let's do a little thought experiment. If I were to think about doing one thing in each of those buckets per day, and I was to create my enough list for the day, I could see that my connection with myself, you know, my self-care could be the one thing is complete my 5-minute journal where I write down my three gratitudes, I write down what would make the day amazing, and a couple of affirmations for the days. And then second, you know, the connection bucket, my relationship with others could be eating breakfast unplugged with my daughter before she goes off to school, right? So not running around getting lunch together and all the pieces and myself getting ready, but actually sitting down at the table with her to have breakfast and have conversation face to face. And then an example of, you know, my contribution, my connection with the world, my creative expression could be writing a newsletter to my community. So those would be my three things, right? 5-minute journal, breakfast with my daughter, writing a newsletter to my community. Another example could be, as the three things for your day, one in each bucket, could be take a bubble bath with some candles, meet two friends for a cup of tea, and have a coaching call with a potential client, right? And that can become the simple list. Okay, have I checked each thing in my list for the day? You know, that one thing that's really important for my self-care, that one thing that's really important for the people that I care about, and that one thing that's really important from how I'm going to show up and care for the world and show up in service. And so what if our enough became that I am doing enough, I have enough, I am enough? So what if we stopped racing with others and, like Matthew McConaughey, just had a race with our future selves and started running a race from that place? And something that I say, you know, when my daughter, my husband and I, we like to run 5Ks together, and we came up with this personal family mantra of my race, my pace, my personal best. So instead of racing someone else's race, what if we just raced with our future selves and really got clear on what it is that we really, really want? And what is that enough list for our whole lives? And then how can we create that enough list for our daily lives to really move closer and closer to that sense of peace and calm and freedom and connection with ourselves and others and with the world. So if you are looking for a more holistic and sustainable way to grow, not just personally, but professionally in your business without sacrificing your sanity, your health, and your relationships, I'd love for you to really create that enough list for yourself and to remind yourself that you are enough, that you're doing enough, and really you have enough already, and still be in the spirit of chasing your future self to really serve in the highest capacity that you can. And if you'd love to learn more about how we can do this work together, how you can really get clear on what your enough list is, I would love to explore what that might look like in working together. And my superpower is being able to support you to reach more people, grow your dream team and your business, and to make a bigger impact in the world. And if you're curious about what that might look like, go to jadaselner.com/work and you can look at my different offerings and apply. I'd love to learn more about your heart, your vision, your dreams. I hope that you have a beautiful day, and reminding you that you are enough. Thank you so much for your heart and attention in listening to Lead with Love. If this message, leading with love in life and business, and remembering the humans and beating hearts behind the numbers and all of that good stuff, I would love for you to take the time to leave an honest review. It would mean the world to me, and it also helps more people find out about the goodness and helping spreading more love in the world, which we really, really need. So I would really appreciate that, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.